I like to think that I just pour my soul into everything that I do, and I think it shows. When I discovered Alcohol Inc., I was working on my PhD. I was stressed to the max, holding down a full-time job, and I needed something that was going to be my release. And I've always turned to art and creativity for that. And when I discovered this medium, it was like opening up the gates and allowing me to really release everything that I was holding in and bottling up onto paper. And then I just kept doing it and doing it, and never had the intention of turning it into a job or anything like that. Alcohol ink is a highly pigmented ink. It's essentially what is used to make markers, but it's just in the liquid form. And so I use it on glossy surfaces, mostly synthetic paper. You can use it on canvas and other surfaces like ceramic, glass, metal. I love working with alcohol ink because it's very fluid. You can mix colors together and it just moves on paper, and there's something very whimsical and freeing about it. My process really starts with how I'm feeling that day. Emotions really dictate kind of how the piece is going to come together. I really use nature as inspiration for my color palette. I take those natural palettes and I make them more whimsical. And so I might intensify the color or kind of think about it a little differently than what you're actually seeing. I start with adding ink, usually as like a small pool of ink first, and then add metallics. The metallic goes into the ink, and then I add isopropyl alcohol to it. And then that allows for it to move across the paper and it becomes very fluid. A lot of the movement and what I'm doing on the paper requires forced air, because you need to force it kind of around whatever surface you're working with. I use that air blaster bulb to kind of blast the air around, and also a hair dryer to move it. And I use silicone brushes. I use those to kind of help move the inks around, because normal paint brushes will kind of soak up that ink. It's very fast drying. The alcohol is what really helps to kind of keep it more fluid. So the more alcohol you add to the ink, then the longer kind of you have for the dry time. I think inks can be very intimidating because there isn't a lot of control. I think the most challenging part is not knowing essentially what it's going to look like when the colors start to merge. I have swatches, which are behind me, but those swatches allow for me to see what some of the undertones are. Those undertones will then mix, and so you have to be very careful to think about how those colors mix. It's part of why I love working with alcohol ink, is it allows me to use kind of like that analytical side of my brain that really starts to dig into, okay, how are these colors gonna mix? What is that gonna look like? Is it gonna create something that is really intense and beautiful, or could it end up muddy and not really what I was hoping for? I don't know if a piece is ever really finished. As an artist, I think there's always something that you look at it and you're like, oh, I could maybe do something here or touch it up here. When you add more ink to what's already on the paper, it's going to shift and move that ink as well. So sometimes it can really disrupt a painting if you add too much or not add enough. And so usually I go based off of feeling. Everything is about feeling for me. If it feels right, then the painting's done for me. I love to teach one-on-one sessions. I had someone reach out. They were just kind of curious to know a little bit more about my process and really just interested in the medium and wanted to give it a try. So I said, well, I could meet with you one-on-one over any type of connection that we could make and teach that individual how I do my process. And it just kind of dawned on me, like, maybe other people want to learn. And I was surprised by people's interest in wanting to meet with me and learn from me. I show them how I paint, and then I give them an opportunity to show me how they're working, and then I provide feedback as they're doing it. They're a lot of fun. What I want people to feel from my art is emotion. I have a response. something that just triggers something for them, whether it's happiness, joy, frustration, whatever it might be, but I want it to spark something in them, something that maybe draws them back to a memory or a thought or something that makes them feel. I love to bring joy to the world and positivity, and I think that I'm able to do that through teaching and just inspiring others to keep doing what they're doing and finding ways to relieve stress and bringing more of that positivity into their life is rewarding for me. I like to see people happy.
Funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.